Hello everyone, I welcome you all to GeekyScript. Today I'm going to show you how to put an HTML website online to the internet. So if you see on my desktop, I have a couple of websites. One is a portfolio website. So if you go inside, we have these three files. Basically, one is index.html, and then we have a main.css file, and we have an images folder that contains some images, right? So if I just simply double click on this file, you can see that it is properly running, but it is running locally on our system, right? So this URL is not accessible globally. So let's say if you want to host this similar type of website online onto the internet, all you need to do is basically first you need to register to GitHub. So let's just open a new tab and type GitHub and hit enter. And one thing is, like, whatever I am showing on this video will be completely free, all right? So you don't need to worry about anything. Just follow this video. So you need to open a new tab of GitHub and search GitHub and just go inside to github.com, and that will show you this page here. You need to sign up, so just provide your email ID and click on sign up for GitHub. You need to basically register. I have already signed in, so I'll just sign in to my GitHub. I'll provide my email ID, password, and then I'll just simply sign in. So that's going to let me into our dashboard of GitHub. So I'll just simply click on this profile icon and I'll go to my profile. So this is my GitHub account. So you need to create one similar account. So when you go to profile, you'll be able to see all this over here. So all you need to do is you need to go to this repositories and you need to create one new repository. So for that, just simply click on this new button and that will create a new repository. So give a repository name. So let's give the repo name as geekyscript.github.io. So this is going to be our website URL. So I'll keep this and I'll just simply click on create repository. So that's going to immediately start creating our repositories. You can see that our GeekyScript repository is actually created over here. So now all you need to do is you need to click on this upload an existing file. So that will show you this window. So here, if you go to your desktop, remember we have created this project called portfolio. So when you double click on it, it shows locally, but we want this to be available globally. So for that, what you need to do is, you need to just drag all these files. So remember this screen. So all you need to do is just simply drag all these files over here. So just drag that. So you can see it is rightly started uploading all of our files. And it is done. So all of our files are rightly uploaded. Just give some commit message like initial commit. And just simply click on commit changes. So processing your files, all files will be uploaded and will be there on our repo. So geekyscript.github.io, all files and folders are rightly uploaded over here, like what we have over here, that same got uploaded. And now all you need to do is you need to go to settings and you need to switch to this pages. So click on that. So that will show you these GitHub pages options over here. Here you need to select this main. You might see master here as well, so it depends. And you need to also select a root. Alright. So since I have created this URL called geekyscript.github.io, so that is my URL. So right now it is auto-populated all these fields. Next step I'm going to show you, just keep watching this video. There'll be one changes that you need to make when you want to upload a second website or a third website. So for the initial website or the first website, the steps are like this. So you need to keep this and everything is rightly set. So if you just simply refresh this, you can see that our site is live at this URL. So when you click on this URL, you can see this geekyscript.github.io is up and running, right? And this is available globally. So from any place on our earth, if you just simply, you know, use this URL on browser, that going to show you this page. All right, it's no longer limited to, you know, this local directory. Now it is available globally. All right, so you can see. So by the way, if you need this type of tutorials, like how did I create this simple portfolio website? So I just created this website for one of my friend in like about 10 or 15 minutes using Tailwind CSS. So if you are eager to know how to create this type of website, you can always, you know, mention that on comment sessions. I'll be happily making a video on that as well. All right. And if I go to this inspect element, and you can see that it is responsive as well. You can switch to, let's say, Pixel 7. So you can see this nav bar, then this hamburger icon. You can switch to project, skills, contact, about section, all that. And it is properly responsive. It's just a single page, you know, website, nothing much, just a simple portfolio website, and it is available globally. Now next, what I am going to show you is, let's say you want to, you know, let's close this folder. So one project you have already hosted, let's say you want to host one more website, like let's say another project that I have created, just a demo project. So if I double click on it, nothing much is here, just a simple hello world HTML file. So nothing much, but it's indeed a project. So let's say you want to host this project. So what you need to do is, you need to again go to GitHub. So okay, close all this and type GitHub. Let's, you know, go inside to our GitHub account again, your profile. So this is our profile. By the way, I don't have much of followers, so it will be good if you follow me, only 3 followers. So if you are really liking this video, you can always follow me. So here, what you need to do is, you need to again go to repositories and you need to create one more repo. So just go to new and give your project name. So I'll just simply give a project called demo. All right, and you can give some description or all different things. Just simply click on create repository. So what it's going to do is, again, it's going to show you this page. You need to go to your, you know, folder. So here is our project. So you need to drag this. Before dragging, you need to click on this upload an existing file, and then you need to drag this, and that will get added over here. You can give some message like initial commit, and just simply click on commit changes. So that will get, you know, added to our project called demo. So now is the trick. So now we need to go to again settings, and you will see these pages over here, and here you can see that all these different options, like that previously it was already populated with main and root, that is no longer showing over here, right? So you need to manually do that now. So you need to, you know, click on this drop down and click on main, and you need to, this is auto populated of root, which is totally fine. So that's all you need to do. All right, second time onwards, this time there will be a change in URL as well. I'm going to show you that. Just keep following this video. So click on save. So everything is fine. You can just simply refresh this, and you can see that our site is again live, right? But this time, if you see that previously our website was like geekyscript.github.io, right? But after that, they have added one slash and given our project called demo. So if you click on this visit site, so you can see again that is up and running, and it is available, you know, right through the internet. So from any place on earth, you can see this project. But you can see the URL now. URL is a bit different now. So if you remove this demo, it's going to show you the previous website that you have created. So this is our initial website, and you need to just give a slash and give your next project name over here. So that is demo, and that project is now showing. So let's say you want to create another project. So that time what will happen is, like, you again create a new repo, and let's say that project name is like website 3. All right, so what will happen is, instead of demo, you need to type website 3, alright, over here. So that will be your third website and so on. And for the initial website, that will be always this the first one. And remember, one more thing is, like, you need to name this file as like index.html, alright. So if you see the other project that I have created, like demo project, that file name is also set as index.html. If you are naming this file something else, let's say I'll go inside and I'll rename this. I'll rename to something else. Let's say I rename to, let's say, home.html, and I'll click on commit changes. So commit changes. So now I'm just simply updating the file name. And now if I, you know, go to browser tab and type demo over here and hit enter, it's going to show you that 404 file is not found, because, you know, it is not recognizing this home.html. It always, you know, seeks for a file called index.html. So unless you, you know, provide that index.html, it's going, not going to recognize. So it is not recognizing this, you know, file name called home.html. To get that, either you type explicitly, like, you know, home.html and hit enter, so then it will get, or else you need to, you know, make this file as index.html. Always remember that. All right so that's like another thing that I wanted to show you. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So that's how you put an HTML website online to the internet, and that is totally free. Don't forget to follow me on GeekyScript, and also don't forget to mention whether you need a more detailed tutorial about how to create this type of website that I've created, a simple portfolio website. So if you want to know that, also you can ask. And also the source code is also, you'll get on our GitHub account. So you can also follow me over here as well. And also don't forget to subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. So don't forget, that will really going to motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. And also, if you're interested, you can also subscribe to our GeekyScript blogging channel. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.